Hello everyone, welcome back. So today I'll be working on yet another PlayStation 2. This one was part of the lot that the other PlayStation came with. And the description didn't say what's wrong with it, it just said for parts not working. But I already plugged it in and it turns on. It outputs video, but the disc tray is not opening. So today I'm gonna open it up, see what's wrong with the disc tray, give it a good clean, and see what else it possibly needs. I'm gonna skip the part of me taking the cover off just to save some time, but you'll see me tearing it down further down to the motherboard and giving it a good clean. So if you're into good cleaning videos, stick around because you'll get to see that. All right, let's get started. All right, let's plug it in and see what it's doing. I can't really see anything obvious right now. The disc is not even spinning. Alright, let's open it up. Alright, there was a clip on the side. And there's another one back here. This thing is filthy. Yuck. Let's try turning it on one more time, see what's going on here. Huh. Now it opens. Okay. I didn't do anything. The disk drive doesn't spin though. All right, let's try a game in here. Cover back on. Let's see if it still works. Okay, it does. Let's see if it'll spin. Like it's spinning and it's reading it. Yeah, I could definitely hear it reading the disc, so that seems fine. I don't know why it was jammed, but now it seems fine. So as you saw, the disc drive works. This opens and closes now. I don't know what was causing the issue, but that seems fine. So I guess there's not much else to do. I'm just gonna open this up and clean it real good and put it back together. Bear with me, I've never taken one of these apart before, so we're gonna learn together. Here we go. Looks like we're missing a screw in here. Or maybe not, I don't know. Okay, that's a lot simpler than I thought it was gonna be. More filth under here. Might be a good idea to unplug it, huh? I'm not sure how this ribbon cable disconnects. Okay, I guess we'll wait. Looks like this is keeping the drive from coming out. Fan is still attached to the motherboard. I'm probably doing this in the wrong order. That's okay. There's a whole bunch of ribbon cables holding the bottom of this. This is not going to be fun to put back together, that's for sure.
There's the fan connector. Even better, it came out from over there. So I need to remember to attach this ribbon cable to there. There's some kind of little bug that was living in here. Guessing I have to take out all these screws. Good news is they all look like the same size screw. Then we got one big one right here. I think now the heat sink should be able to come off. There we go. That's interesting. They don't use thermal paste. They just use thermal pads on the whole thing. Okay. Cool. All right, let's give her a clean. Alright, I got this old broken, cracked tub. It's the only thing I have at the moment. Get some clean water in it. Adding some soap. Let the cleaning begin. Thank you. looks like all this yellowing is not coming off. But hopefully it'll get the smoke smell out of it. Dog's going crazy at the neighbor. I'm gonna rinse this with some clean water afterwards too. I probably won't show you that part. Let the stuff soak too. That might help. This one is real nasty. A little plastic bit of something. Alright, I'm gonna let it all soak and I'll rinse it, dry it, and I'll see you when it's time to put it back together.
Alright, while that stuff is soaking, let's clean up this disk drive, and the motherboard, and the power supply unit with some isopropyl alcohol. I'm surprised that laser still works, because it's actually very dusty.
I know you're not supposed to do that, but I need to do it. You'll be fine.
It just keeps coming.
all the grease is dried out and sticky. So I'm gonna reapply some fresh grease on that. On the rails. I wish I could open this, but I guess I'll have to wait until it's plugged in. Cotton ball and clean that lens. I know this is not ideal. Let's put this thing back together. So I let these things soak for a while, and that helped cleaning it a lot. It helped dissolve some of that nicotine stains. And then I scrubbed it some more and rinsed it off. And they came out pretty good. Not perfect, but there's still some staining. Much better than it was though. Still a little bit of yellow.
One eternity later.
Let's plug it in. See what happens. Let's hope nothing goes boom. We got a red light. Green light. Fan working. I saw the laser head moving. That part is working. That would be a perfect opportunity to clean inside there. So let me do that real quick. Alright, let's put some grease on that too. I think now I got everything except for the top case. Let's test it. Got a light. That works. Let's try gaming it. That started reading it much faster than it did last time. Remember when I was first testing it? It took a while for the disc to start. Try it again.
All right, I'm just gonna finish putting it back together and then we'll do a final test. See you then. All right, I have this thing plugged in. Let's see if it'll play a game. I mean, we know it spins the disc, but let's see if we'll actually load it. But yeah, as you can see, it works. All it really needed was a cleaning. I don't know why the disc tray was stuck, because as soon as I removed that top cover off of it, it just started working. And now it's still working. Cleaned everything up, lubed it, and put it back together. And now I have two Japanese PS2s, and I don't know what I'm gonna do with them. All right, well, it's been fun. Thank you.